last season with the China Trust Whales. 7-12, no saves, 3.53 earned run average, 122 innings, 111 hits, 56 runs. Will you hear this? 125 strikeouts. Last year.
In how many innings?
122.1.
Ooh, so Houtini, a left-hander.
A sneaky left-hander, no doubt.
There's a ground ball off the bat of Jeff Salazar hustling down the line, but he can't beat the throw from the second baseman, Will Rimes. And there is a one away, a lefty-lefty. And Houtini retires Salazar. One down here in the Indians, half of the fifth, and this will bring up Garrett Jones. 13 runs. If you're going to do it, make sure it's within that division. Pierce reaches out, rolls it to third. Hesman over to second for one. Around the horn, it's a 5-4-3 double play, and the inning is over. No runs, a hit, and a man. And Saturday evening against Toledo at 7 o'clock, and then Easter Sunday, 2 o'clock, the first pitch as Larry Broadway takes ball one from Houtini, who's working his second inning of relief for the Mudheads, in relief of the starter, Chris Lambert, who went four. There's a strikeout that is. 1-1 the count to Broadway. The Tribe DH has walked twice and scored. Saturday and Sunday, the Indians will be passing out their schedule magnet. So come to the park Saturday or Sunday. Pick up your schedule magnet for the season, the first of many souvenir giveaways throughout this season. Here's the 1-2. Broadway swings and misses. He's down on strikes. First time that he has been retired. First strikeout for Taney. Wall calendar. Did you get one of those last year?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. The pictures are great. Bill Gentry's pictures of the players in action. Here's the pitch. It's down low. 1-0 the count.
Thought the Indians were going to keep Dave Davidson up in the bullpen. He got up, walked down to the pitcher's mound, picked up the rosin bag, threw it back down, and
took a seat. Here's the 1-0. There's a high fly ball off the bat of Phillips. Way back in left. Ramirez is at the track. It's gone. And Andy Phillips has hit the first home run of the season for the Indians. Sidearm throw is low and it's in the dirt. Backhand attempt by Roberson. He comes up short.
Now, some of the school systems are on spring break this week, but nonetheless, people are hanging in, taking advantage of the nice night.
B finds the plate. 1-1 the count to McCutcheon. They put a lot of pressure on the Pirates, and they admitted that from his performance that he put on in spring training. Here is the 1-1. Swing and a miss. Took something off. He had McCutcheon out in front. Now, it's not unusual to see a prospect of McCutcheon's stature not break camp and then get the opportunity a few weeks into the season. To be reminded of that, just rewind to last year. Jay Bruce started the season with the Louisville Bats. Here's the 1-2. McCutcheon checks his swing and appeal to first. Held up, says Adrian Johnson. A few seasons ago, Grady Sizemore put together a terrific spring. Cleveland ships him to Buffalo. He's there for a few weeks. Before you know it, he's the center fielder every single day for the Cleveland Indians.
Right-hander Freddie Dulce warming for the Toledo Mudheads. Left-hander Dave Davidson up in the Indians' pen.
The 2-2 pitch is fouled out of play. And the Pirates, you know, they were very upfront to Andrew and in the media. Neil Huntington's general manager's quotes, it's pretty refreshing when you see the GM of a club say, hey, it's a business decision to send Andrew down here. You don't want to start his clock just yet. 6 full years in the big leagues. That's how long the Pirates can have McCutcheon under the current contract, who swings and misses on the 2-2. Good pitch by Knee, tied him up inside. But that spot would have only been the backup to Jack Wilson, and they want Brian to play every day and not sit on the bench in Pittsburgh, so that's why he is here in Indy. Swings and misses, count evens up into a piece. Do you want someone who you think might be one of your future middle infielders getting 1 to 2 starts a week in Pittsburgh, or 6 or 7 starts down in the minor leagues?
Well, there was an awful lot of talk this winter that Jack Wilson would not be back as the Pirates shortstop for 2009.
Is the 2-2 inside and stopped by the catcher?
Whatever happened or didn't happen, that deal never came about. Wilson is there, still playing well, but you gotta believe that his days are numbered, even if he finishes this season as a Pirate.
There's a chance you lose 3 infielders this year by the trading deadline, and Adam LaRoche, Freddie Sanchez, and Jack Wilson. Payoff pitch, runner goes from first. Bixler drives this into the gap in right center field, but Raymore tracking it down makes the catch at the edge of the track.